East. And all this rain is bringing concerns of flash flooding. Right now, the majority of the state, especially west of the bay, under a flash flood watch. And that means at any moment, there could be conditions that are conducive to flash flooding. Where we do have a flash flooding warning out for York County, and that means the conditions are even ripe right now for localized street flooding and flooding along creeks and riverways. So this is definitely something to keep in mind as you commute home from work. Take it easy out there. You want to slow down, be safe, and if you come across any standing water on the road, your best bet is to try to turn around rather than to drive through it. You never know how deep it is, how dangerous it could be. That's always your best bet. So flash flooding will be a major concern. We've seen a lot of clouds stuck across the area today, and this has really kept the temperatures down. Believe it or not, much of the state is still in the 60s. It's even cooler right now than where we started off this morning. And we're going to see these clouds continue as we have the remnants of Lee now situated right into the northern tier of Georgia. This is shifting off towards the north and east. We're actually going to see some warmer air lift back over the state. This may not only bring more rain, but the chance for thunderstorms. And as Lee continues to head our way through the next couple of days, we will be talking about plenty of rain. We're tapping into that moisture from the Gulf, and it's going to continue to produce all the wet weather. Now, I do want to mention the slight chance for severe weather. Very slight in nature. However, just in the southern tier of Maryland, there's a possibility that some of these thunderstorms could strengthen. And it's not out of the question there could be isolated rotation with any of them. So I do want to mention that there could be isolated severe weather with any thunderstorm that does pop up, mainly in southern Maryland. Now we have to keep Katia in mind. So much going on in the weather center. But fortunately, with all this activity in the east, looks like Katia will steer off towards the east. She'll make the closest approach to us Thursday night into Friday morning. Likely to stay well offshore, but rip currents and rough seas could be a problem for the eastern shore. Tonight, we're expecting heavy rain. Some of the showers likely in the area tonight. Cloudy skies, lows drop down into the 60s. We'll be back to the 70s tomorrow, but rain stays in the forecast through Friday, then drier conditions for the weekend.